Hey, welcome back to Robinson Foundry. In this video, I'll be making a set of aluminum bronze ninja stars that glow in the dark for hours, because nothing says stealth like a set of glowing ninja stars. Like many of my projects, I started this one in Fusion 360. I came up with a few different designs, but I settled on this one because I like the idea of the entire profile glowing in the dark. Once I was happy with my design, it was time to 3D print some patterns. These patterns will be used to make a sand mold, so I printed them at the highest resolution possible on my 3D printer. Once the patterns were done printing, I installed pins on one side so that both parts fit together perfectly. To make the molds, I used a special oil sand called petrobond. This sand does an amazing job at capturing detail in the pattern, so it's important to have really nicely made patterns. It's a good idea to use different crucibles for every metal and alloy being melted to avoid contamination. Unfortunately, I didn't have a crucible for melting aluminum bronze, so I just used this crucible that I've used for melting silver. The aluminum bronze that I used for this project contains about 90% copper and 10% aluminum by weight. It's an incredibly strong metal for what it is, and it'll be perfect for a set of ninja stars. Fortunately, I had a bunch of scrap left over from previous castings, so I didn't have to start from scratch. I wanted to make sure that the metal was hot enough to flow into all the points on the stars, so I let it heat up to around 2100 degrees Fahrenheit before pouring it into the molds. I'm always amazed at how strong this alloy is. Check out how well this super thin piece of metal that flowed up through the vent resists bending. Any other metal that I'm able to cast with would just bend like a wet noodle. These castings turned out really well, so the next step was to start cleaning them up. Once Once I had all the excess metal removed, I cleaned them up with a sandblaster. Some of you requested that I figure out a way to record the sandblasting. Well, I did try to do that by making a mount for a small camera, but unfortunately that didn't record, but I'll definitely try again next time. After sandblasting, I polished the Ninja Stars using this really nice deburring wheel made by 3M. I don't use it often, but when I do, it does a great job. Next, I used some hand files, followed by a little polishing bit on my Dremel. I left grinding the edges for the very last step because I didn't want to have to worry about accidentally poking myself. 16 points is a lot to look out for. At this point, they were really starting to look great, but I still needed to make them glow in the dark. This is the glow powder I used. It's made of strontium aluminate, and it's pretty incredible stuff. Once charged up with light, it'll continue to glow for hours, and ever since using this stuff, I've been geeking out over it and coming up with all sorts of ideas. I'll include affiliate links in the description for items I've used in this video if you're interested in checking them out for yourself. To get these Ninja Stars to glow, I just used some regular epoxy resin and then just mixed in a bunch of the glow powder to taste. It was definitely a bit tricky getting the epoxy neatly onto the stars without making a big mess, but I was able to do it. This was my first time incorporating both epoxy and glow powder into a project, and I'm really happy with how it turned out. All the grinds are really even and uniform, and I like how the resin blends into the color of the bronze. Okay, let's see how these things look in the dark. The initial super bright glow does dissipate within just a minute or two, but the glow powder continues to emit light for many hours afterwards. I guess the big question here is whether the stars will actually stick into things, so let's find out. They actually work pretty well, and it's really satisfying to see them stick into the target. Well, I had a lot of fun making these and testing them out. Let me know if you want to see more projects incorporating resin. Like I said, I have plenty of ideas. Well, I hope you enjoyed watching me make these, and if you did, please let me know what you think in the comments, give the video a thumbs up, and subscribe for future videos. Well, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.